was an actor called Michael Landon. And he was in a very, he was in a film called I Was a Teenage Werewolf, Roger Corman's movie, because I worked a lot with Roger Corman as an agent. And so I began representing Michael Landon, and he became a very famous TV star. That was my first client, in the Ponderosa, Little Joe.
Moving ahead, you worked on Star Wars.
Star Wars?
Yeah. We would like to know, how did it start?
I got a job as vice president of 20th Century Fox in London for all the international operations. And Star Wars had just completed shooting in London. And the post-production was taking place there. So the president of the studio came to London, and we went out to Elstree Studios, where they were doing the mixing and post-production work, and I was introduced to George Lucas and Gary Kurtz, the producer, as the representative of 20th Century Fox, and my job was to liaise with them on the release and the marketing of Star Wars. And so I supervised for Fox all the different cinemas that Star Wars was going to open in, and the prints and all of the publicity. And what we decided to do was, because we were releasing in stereo, so we went, I sent a representative to each cinema in Europe, all over Europe, in France and Italy, Spain, Netherlands, Scandinavia, to check each cinema before Star Wars opened. And we had to make sure that all of the speakers were in phase, that the sound was right, because it was going to be released in Dolby stereo. And so that was the beginning of my involvement with Star Wars. It was on the post-production, the marketing, the sailing. And then, of course, the second Empire Strikes Back, I was there at the beginning of the film. The director was Irving Kirshner, who I had known and worked with in Hollywood before. And so my job was to liaise with Lucas, although he wasn't the director of Empire. He was the producer and the writer.
And how